श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे The symptoms of the diseases are examined to establish the presence of a particular disease. Similarly, if we are walking spiritual path, if we are really walking in the right direction, and if we have reached the destination of our non-dual self, What are the symptoms? In our scriptures, there is one topic, and that topic is describing the wise man. In Bhagavad Gita, we come across in three places. One is in the second chapter, who is a man of steady wisdom? In the 12th chapter, we come across Who is a devotee? He who has devotion in his heart. What we do outside is upasana. Please make this very clear. Upasana is external, devotion is internal. Upasana is action predominant and devotion is knowledge predominant. Because knowledge and devotion, they are not two, it's one and the same. So, who is a devotee? So the teacher says, Adveshta sarva bhutana maitra karuna evacha, 20 signs are given. So he is a devotee. Then the third one. Who he has transcended the prakriti of three gunas. In the 14th chapter, Bhagavan says that he who has transcended the limitations of the prakriti, the matter, maya, sattva, rajas, tamas, who is he? So, prakasham cha pravrittim cha moham eva cha pandava na dveshti sam pravrittani na nivrittani kangshati. When it is prakasham sattvaguna, knowledge, quickly able to understand, pravritti, activities, and mohamevacha, dullness. Whatever may be the modes operating in the life of a great master, na dveshti sam pravrittani, he doesn't hate anything. Suppose morning time I am doing meditation and one day I could not get up. Oh God, why did it happen? Okay, I'll punish myself. I will not take food for 3 days. This is not the way the wise people are. Don't torture yourself. It is natural. Sometimes sattva guna will be prominent, sometimes rajo guna, sometimes tamo guna. If we have gone beyond these three gunas, then the presence or absence, their activation or non-activation will not create an iota of disturbance in our self. We will remain the same. In short, these topics are given in our scriptures not to evaluate the Mahatmas. Adveshta sarva bhutana maitra karune vacha, you make a list. Look at the Babaji. Next. No. It is not for giving a certificate by fools like us to the great masters. Then, this description in the scriptures is given as the pointers. If this happens in our life, then we are on the right track. This is the meaning. See? सो विज्ञात ब्रह्म तत्वस्य यथा पूर्वं न संस्कृति ही अस्ति चेन्न स विज्ञात ब्रह्म भावो बहिर्मुखः. विज्ञात ब्रह्म तत्वस्य ही हु हैज दस एस्टैब्लिश हिमसेल्फ इन दिस नॉन ड्यूअल एब्सोल्यूट रियलिटी देन यथा पूर्वं न संस्कृति. He will be living in the same world, but his vision has undergone a change. Earlier, he was looking at the world as a place for indulgence. Now, he looks at the world as his own expanse. Yasmin sarvani bhutani atma eva abhut vijanataha tasya ko mohakka shokaha ekatva anupashyataha. He who has discovered that this whole world is nothing but my own expansion, then how can he have any doubt, confusion, anger, greed, hatred? This cannot happen. Therefore, here the teacher says, Vijnata Brahma Tattvasya, if we have established ourselves in this reality, Yatha Purvanma Sansruti, our life will not have the same expressions as earlier. Earlier expressions were when the worldly things we see, we either have comments, desires, hatred, etc. In Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, probably in the 11th canto, this thought comes. Very beautiful thought. Don't praise anybody, don't condemn anybody. Don't ask anybody to come and don't ask anybody to go. That is the reason I do not encourage people coming to my place. You know the secret I should not tell, but I am telling. When I go to somebody's house, I have freedom. I can walk away. But if somebody comes and sits in your house, you can't tell, bhai, jao. Then what do you do, Swamiji? I go to bathroom. Yad gatva na nivartante tad dhamo paramam. See, in this manner, vijnata brahma tattvasya yatha purvam na sansruti, neither he creates friends nor enemies, nor creating any list of, you know, directory of, you know. Our Swami Khandaji Maharaj devotees suggested him, Maharaji, your devotees are around the world, why not we create a directory of Maharaji's devotee? Maharaji said, no need. He said, no, Maharaji, because in Rotary Club, Lion Club, they have, so people can meet. So he said, do you know why they have that directory? Where I go to New York, very expensive. So I find out. Mil gaya one lion. So I phone him. Hello, hello, I am a lion from the South Africa. You are from where? I am from Antarctica. So your expenditure is reduced and you want to utilize that relationship for your social benefit. No. See, friends, therefore, this kind of creating a samaj, organization, etc. is not the way. Yatha purvam sansruti asti chet, if his life quality has not changed, then sa bahirmukha, he is extrovert. And as a result, so na brahma vidnyata brahma bhavaha, he is nowhere near the reality. How simple it is. Therefore, the lakshanas, the symptoms of the wise man, these are the pointers for us as the spiritual practice. Like second chapter, Bhagavan says, dukkheshu anudvigna manaha, sukheshu vigata spruhaha, Vita raga bhaya krodaha stitadihi muni uchate. A person who doesn't become miserable because of the miseries, and he who is not attached to the comforts, and he who is free from the modifications of the mind, such as desire, anger, fear, etc., he is a man of steady wisdom. So if we have to practice spiritual life, what we have to do? These symptoms which are indicated, they are not meant for giving certificate to the Mahatmas, but they are the one which we have to follow and inculcate in our life. Otherwise, we go on evaluating. The other day, one person who asked me, somebody wrote on WhatsApp, "Swamiji, I am talking to so and so, and do you know that particular Mahatma, some name was referred, what do you think about it? Whether he is real or just superficial?" So I told, "Are you appointed for evaluating Mahatmas? And what do you know about Mahatma? You are a useless Atma. Forget about Chota Atma. Never, never try to evaluate anybody in life. Never judge anybody." There was a devotee to a great Mahatma, and he wrote the biography of the Mahatma. And he showed, "Sir, without your permission, of course, collecting the information, I have written your biography. Please bless it." "Oh, you have written? Show me. And he was talking to him and without reading anything. And like, you know, we play with the thing. He started tearing one by one page and talking to him. And the person who wrote, he was, you know, those days there were no soft copy. And then he said, "What you must have written, what you have understood me, I am beyond your understanding. So this book contains not my biography, but your misunderstanding about me." How true it is. See? Therefore, autobiography of a Dumbo, never get into that. Whose autobiography we write? Only the waker. What about the dreamer, deep sleeper, deep and a samadhi? That we don't include. Because for us, waker is the real. Because body is I. See, friends. Therefore, vijnata brahma tattvasya yatha apurvam na sansruti. He doesn't take this world as he was taking earlier. This world is real. We have to serve this world. We have to do something good. Sarva bhuta hite rataha. All this is rubbish. Have the courage. See? Otherwise, an NGO will be born. See? NGO is legalization of corruption. See? That is what the meaning of CA also. CA means corruption authenticated. These are the people. There was one talk given by our Prime Minister to the CAs. And there he has told so straight away. He said, "Your signature has more value than my signature." See? There are so many shells. These are not the shells the enemies bombard, but these are the shell company. They produce the shells and create problems. Therefore, yatha purvamna sansruti, don't get lost in this world. Whatever is happening, that is also not claimed. Let it happen. Like the flower, doesn't give fragrance. Flower has fragrance. The sun doesn't give light. The sun has light. And therefore, there are no efforts. So when the flower goes and lands on the head of the god, the flower doesn't feel, "I'm so lucky." And if it lands on the dead body, like yesterday we have seen. All of you have seen? No. Not seen. Afraid? For that, to see the dead body, you have to go up. We went up. We saw that everybody came down. So whether the flower lands on a god or a dead body, it makes no difference. See? Therefore, asti chenna sa vidnyata brahma bhavaha bahirmukaha. Therefore, we have nothing to do in this world and nowhere to go. Try this. Sukhadyanubhavo yavat tavat prarabdhamishyate falat falodayaha kriya purva nishkriyo nahi kutrachita. Now here one of the most important topic which most of the people suffer is taken for discussion. Sukha adi anubhavaha yavat tavat prarabdhamishyate. Till such time you think joy and sorrows are real. And therefore you become joyful and sorrowful. And then we go and ask the Mahatmas, Mahatmaji, I have not done anything bad to anybody. Why all the miseries are coming to me? Now what will be the approach of the Mahatmas? To make you more miserable or to bring you out of the miseries? So they want to help you to come out of the miseries. Now what is our misery? Cause of our misery. The cause of our misery is we have become expert in blaming others for our miseries. Default settings. If I am a father, the cause of my misery is bacche, children. If I am a mother, the cause of my misery is the children. Then what will be my approach in life? Try to improve the children. We forget they cannot be improved. They are our children. They are gone case. One thing I'll tell you, you may not be knowing. Gents, be aware. See, we have got two aspects. One is pure consciousness. Second is prakriti, through which consciousness expresses as life. Now, prakriti has the five great elements, five jnanendriyas, five karmendriyas, and also the mind, which has four aspects. Mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar. Buddhi means intellect. Intellect falls in prakriti, in matter. Therefore, if the mother is intelligent, then only the children are intelligent. If the mother is not intelligent and father is very intelligent, it will be going the wrong direction. See? Therefore, Benjamin Franklin was asked by Marilyn Monroe, then why not we marry so that, you know, the child will be beautiful like me and intelligent like you? He said, if it happened the other way. Therefore, we are expert in blaming others for our miseries. So what the teachers want, come out of your problems and once for all. So we are told that all the miseries that you have because of the karma that you have done in the last life. And we as Dumbo accept it. Do you remember your last life? No. Karma that you have done? No. But start accepting. See? And we take it so seriously. And the fools are good in that way. So, then what happened? You have tortured this lady in your last life. Therefore, she has come as your wife in this life. And she is now taking revenge. No, but I don't know. It doesn't matter. You know or you don't know. This is the result of your karma. Then what is this? This is called a prarabdha karma. Then we are made more complicated. There are three types of karma. సంచిత కర్మ, ప్రారంభ కర్మ అండ్ ఆగామి కర్మ, అండ్ యూ గెట్ లాస్ట్ ఇన్ దట్ కర్మ కర్మ కర్మ. మోరల్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ ఇస్ నాట్ అండర్స్టూడ్. సావిత్రి వాజ్ ఎ గ్రేట్ పతివ్రత, డివోటెడ్ టు హర్ హస్బెండ్. వెన్ హర్ హస్బెండ్ డైడ్, షీ ఫాట్ విత్ యమరాజ్. యు కెన్ ఇమాజిన్, వెన్ ఎ లేడీ స్టార్ట్ ఫైటింగ్, ఎనీబడి హ్యాస్ టు గివ్ అప్. వాట్ అబౌట్ డెత్? నథింగ్. సో యమరాజ్ సేడ్, ఐ అక్సెప్ట్ మై డిఫీట్, టేక్ యువర్ వైఫ్ హస్బెండ్ బ్యాక్. హస్బెండ్ కేమ్ బ్యాక్ అలైవ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద డెత్ హౌస్. మోరల్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ, మోరల్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ ఈస్, ఈఫ్ ద వైఫ్ ఈస్ సో డెడికేటెడ్ టు ద హస్బెండ్, షీ కెన్ ఈవెన్ డిఫీట్ ద డెత్, అకార్డింగ్ టు మహాభారత్. ఇఫ్ యూ ఆస్క్ మీ, బికాస్ ఎవ్రీబడి హ్యాస్ ఒక ఫ్రీడమ్ టు రైట్ ద మోరల్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ. ఫర్ మీ ద మోరల్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టోరీ ఈజ్, యూ క్యాన్ బి సేవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ డెత్ బట్ నాట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద వైఫ్. షీ విల్ ఫాలో యూ వేర్ ఎవర్ యూ గో. See, friends, instead of understanding these principles, we get carried away and then we are told. The prarabdha karma, that we just started creating this body, you have to go through. This is told only to those who take joy and sorrows very seriously. Therefore it is said here, sukha adi anubhavo yavat tavat prarabdha mishrate. Till such time you take joy sorrows as real, then you want to know where from the joy sorrows have come. Oh, this is your prarabdha. In the last life you must have done something bad, therefore you got it. Not knowing even the correct meaning of this word prarabdha, one lady told me, Swamiji, I see you on YouTube. What is my prarabdha that I hear you every day? I said, it is my prarabdha that people like you hear. So, here the teacher says, phalodayaha kriya purva. No karma phala can happen without the doer behind it. So, we have done something good or bad. So action plus doership is karma. So kriya phalodaya kriya purva nishkriyo nahi kutrachit. And if there is no doer, no karma phala can happen. See, friends, not understanding this basic, we get lost in this logic, karma karma karma. I think I told you, in one hotel in Europe, this, you know, Europeans, Westerners, they are very crazy about this karma, karma, karma. So there was one restaurant where we went for taking tea, coffee. Big board, karma, K-A-R-M-A. My friend asked, Swamiji, what should we order? I said, don't have to order anything. Why? Prarabdha will come. When you go to karma restaurant, you cannot order anything. They say, hey, what is your Sanjit? Tak, 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 list of Sanjit. Prarabdha means today's special dishes. So, nishkriyo nahi kutrachit. Now here, the basic principle we have to understand. If this doership is not accepted as real, if I am body is not accepted as real, if joy and sorrows experiences do not overpower us, then we will never ask about karma, karma, karma. Drop this. Don't give too much importance to this karma. One person asked me this question. He said, Swamiji, you always tell be happy, and Lord Buddha said, sarvam dukkham, everything is misery. Whom should we believe? You or Buddha? I said, that depends on you. These are the options available. See? This glass is half filled. Now, I don't know what you are looking at. If you are looking at the milk half, you will lift it and drink it and enjoy. And if you are looking at the emptiness, you see this glass is only half empty. You suffer. Exactly in this world, if you give importance to the miseries, suffering, you are caught up in prakriti. This is the same thing exactly what Patanjali does. All the time in prakriti, prakriti, prakriti. Chitta vritti nirodha. And when you conquer your mind, then what you do, then again from that prakriti, the hidden or dormant potentialities start manifesting. And those potentialities are called as the siddhis. And then you start playing in this world. Bless somebody, curse somebody. And this is not spiritual life. See, friends, it is so important. So, till such time, we have this notion that joy, sorrows are misery, real, I am body, I am unfortunate, why I get only this thing, others are not getting, then you are a perfect patient for getting cheated by the karma fellows. If you want to hold on to the Lord. We have more faith in Shani Graha, Mangal Graha, Budh Graha. The worst is the Duragraha. That we don't want to remove. Duragraha is obsession that I am the body. Therefore, this prarabdha is only for those who give too much importance to the miseries or the joy. Remember, anything that comes and goes is a imagination of the mind. Object remains the same. Place remains the same. Your mind can never experience the same thing from the same place, from the same time. It will change. Because mind can never remain attracted toward the same thing or a place for a longer period of time. First day when we came to this place, when you looked at it, that time, all our mouths were open and with the kumbhak, ah! Now, they are not giving good breakfast. Disgusting. What happened to this? Oh, this is okay. If you thus learn from your experiences that your mind can never remain attracted towards anything or anybody in the whole world for all the time. And this mind is making us dance. We don't understand. See, therefore we keep on going here, going there, and we want a world which is convenient to us, that is good. See, therefore this prarabdha is a catch, it is not the reality. How it is? Aham brahmeti vijnanat kalpa koti shatarjitam sanchitam vilayam yati prabodhar svapna karmayata. Aham brahmeti vijnanat. When we come to discover that I am the infinite, conscious, blissful existence, then kalpa koti shatarjitam sanchitam karma vilayam yati. All your total past karmas are dissolved. See? If there is a cave, and in that cave, there is never entrance of sunlight. So the cave was... My gestures give him some funny signals. And then he does his own job. I had to check it. So, when anything is told, The first thing we have to understand, what is the import? What is the purpose this is taught? Anything. Creation. The theory of creation. There are dozens of theory of creation. In Taittiriya Upanishad, there are five elements. In Chandogya Upanishad, there are three elements. Now keep fighting. This is right or that is right? In one Upanishad, it is said, he thought and the world was created. In third Upanishad, it is said, he desired and the world is created. Now, out of so many theories of creation, which is right? The right thing is, the theories of creation are not told to prove that there is a creation or there is no creation. The theory of creation is proved that you are the source of everything. If you are not there, the world doesn't exist. See, like in case of coma, the person who is in coma is not there. Only body is there and life is there. For him, there is no world. What is happening to the other people and whether they have got money or not, they are discussing whether to remove the tubes or not, but that person is no more there. And therefore, this world doesn't exist. So where is this world? The world is in me. See, friends, and if I is not there, world doesn't exist. It is for this purpose the theories of creation are told. In the same manner, this karma siddhanta is told, aham brahmeti vijnanan kalpa koti shatarjitam sanchitam karma vilayam yati. Whatever may be the past that you have imagined in your life, that we have gone through many, many lives. Like in Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter, Bhagavan says, manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid yatati siddhe yatatam api siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvataha. Or in the same chapter he says, bahunam janmanamante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlavaha. After many, many lives, one comes to know the truth and then he is able to see my presence everywhere. That doesn't mean he is talking about this. What means? Don't bother how worst sinner you are. By this Brahmajnana, in a fraction, like the old darkness from the cave is just removed. Exactly the same way. Don't go into the length of the past. In the fourth chapter, Bhagavan says, api chedasi paapebhya sarvebhya paapakruttamaha sarvam jnanaplaveneiva vrijinam santarishasi. Even if you are holding a doctorate in committing sins, yet with this Brahmajnanam, everything will be erased. Like the old darkness is erased by one matchstick you burn, everything is gone. See, friends, but if we start giving importance to this, no, why all the miseries come to me? Because you are attractive. See? Don't get carried away by all those dumb thoughts. Aham brahmeti vijnanam kalpa koti shatarjitam sanchitam vilayam yati prabodhat svapna karmayat. Like whatever good or bad we have done in the dream, and when we are out of the dream in the waking experience, will we go and tell the police, please arrest me, I have come to surrender. What you have done? I have killed my wife. But from your face it looks you can't kill even a mosquito. Where did you kill? Give the details. I killed my wife in the dream. So what the police will say? You are a gentleman. but you have come to a wrong place, go to a mental hospital. This is a police station. The moment the dreamer disappears, everything is over. In the same manner, the moment that I am body, I am a soul, this wrong notion disappears. All your sin merit has no meaning. But we are unable, not unable, we don't want to drop the past. Again and again the same old story. And in that we, many times I have seen a few places, we take a revenge of our past on ourselves. One example I'll tell you about this. There was one lady from a very rich, very good family, and husband was a Hitler. So this poor lady has no freedom for anything in her life. She has to just listen, listen, listen. And one day the husband died, and millions were left behind. After he died, could you imagine what this old lady could do? You cannot imagine, I tell you. Within 2 days, 3 days, she changed all the draperies, all the furnitures, all the crockeries. So her children, daughter started asking, because daughter was also a grandmother, but she was an old lady. She was about 80, 80 plus. She started doing this thing and changed all her wardrobe, bought all kinds of funny, funny clothes in the market. Within a period of 10, 15 days, she spent more than maybe a million. So when she was asked, she said, "Don't talk to me, I'll do whatever I want." And one day, again, "But we do it, we know proper, why you are doing it?" She said, "I am taking a revenge. In my whole life, I was not allowed to buy even a matchbox. He was such a terrible monster, the dead husband. Now I will see who comes and stops me. I just want to spend all the money before I die." See, friends, such reactionary people, do you think for them this Atma Bodho Upanishad is there? Therefore, it is Aham Brahmeti Vijnanan Kalpakoti Shatarjitam. Drop your past, good or bad. There is no bad absolute in this world. There is no good absolute in this world. It is only relative. Absolute is only Paramatma. Blowing the railway lines during the British rule in India was a patriotic action. Today, when the same thing is done, it is a terrorist action. Action is the same. See, my friends, therefore, drop all the past completely, 100%, and start living fresh, as if newly born. The real spiritual practice is, I went to somebody's house, real spiritual practice. And I was supposed to take dinner there, and husband and wife, they were talking, and wife said, "You don't know anything." This much only I heard when I entered. So it was not a new thing, it is a usual thing. So I didn't bother. Then she said, "Swamiji, tell him he doesn't know anything." I said, "Mama, had he known anything, he would not have married you. It's good he doesn't know anything." "No, his phone is hanging up and he troubles me. What do I know about the phone?" So I told him, "Go and ask Swamiji." "Now look here, his phone is hanging, and ask Swamiji." So he says, "Swamiji, I am referred to you. Tell me what I should do." Then I told him, I said, "Okay, start the phone." He started. "Go to settings." He went to settings. Click, he clicked. Now there is a list of options. There is one option, Reset factory settings. Click that. Yes, he clicked. You know, there is another message. All data will be erased. You say yes. He did yes. I said, now start. He started. It became perfectly on it. Oh, what happened? I said, exactly this is what happens in our life. By factory settings, we are all cheerful, happy, innocent, pure. But then why the phone hangs? Keep on free download. The device cannot handle it. The device is not meant for that. But we keep on downloading all rubbish and one day the device hangs on. In the same manner, we have collected so much of unwanted data. Delete it. Reset your factory settings. That is spiritual life. Not going forward, go backward. Come back to your own self. See? And how simple technique is? Past, select, shift, delete. That's it. With one click, every spiritual thing is over. No, but Swamiji, suffer silently. Sanchitam vilayam yati prabodhar svapna karmavat. The moment we are out of the dream, everything disappears. Exactly the same way. The moment we are out of this waking dream, start living through the body, start living through the sense organs, start living through the mind, the quality of life will change. See? Swam asangam udasinam parijnaya nabho yatha na shlishyate yati kinchit kadachit bhavi karma bihi. So the three karmas are there. First is prarabdha karma we have spoken of in the 49th verse. Then second is sanchita karma, the accumulated karma we have taken into account in 50th verse. Now the agami karma. Swam asangam udasinam parijnaya nabho yatha. When one comes to discover unattached above all, like the space. Space supports everything, is not attached to anything. Space supports everything, doesn't get influenced by anything. Two things, not attached and not getting influenced. Therefore, udasinam parijnaya nabho yatha na shlishyate yati kinchit. Such a great master, such a great seeker of truth, na shlishyate, he is no more influenced by, touched by all the past, good or bad in his life, nor he will be influenced by all the future that he is doing in the present. See? Naiva kinchit karomiti yukto manneta tattvavit. This is the practice. When we are not doing anything, why should we worry about what is happening to the world? Have you created the world? No. Relax. But we keep on worrying. I don't know what is going to happen in the future. Nothing has happened in the present. What can happen in the future? In this manner, na shrishyate yadi kinchit kadachit bhavi karma bihi. So in short, neither the prarabdha karma of the present life, nor the sanchita karma, the accumulated karma of all the past lives, and agami karma, the karma which will be born in the next life as a result of our activity in this life, all these three types of karmas do not touch or influence the great masters because they are abiding in the absolute reality. Na nabho ghata yogena sura gandhena lipyate tatha atma upadhi yogena tat dharmaihi na eva lipyate. Just like the space in a pot, ghata yogena nabha sura gandhena na lipyate. If the liquors are kept in the pot, because of the liquor, the space in the pot is not contaminated in the same manner. Tatha atma upadhi yogena. Be attentive. Therefore, if you are a man and married, therefore you are a husband, and if you are not disturbed, frustrated because you are a husband, you are realized man. But if you are disturbed, frustrated because of the wife, then you are a realized husband. Or decide. See, upadhi yogena. Whether it is a total space or a little space, the space will never leave its original quality. Exactly the same way. Whether Paramatma that we are is without the conditioning of the Panchakoshas or with the conditioning of the Panchakoshas can never ever touch us, influence us. Therefore, we have been telling you again and again, whether you want or you don't want, whether you know or you don't know, you are divine. This is too much, huh? See, friends. But what happens? We want to do something. Spiritual sadhana we want to do. Yoga, go here and there. This disease of doing has to be rejected. Like I told you the story of our Parashuramji. When he was told, he said, Brahmananda, relax, yaar, forget about everything. But that we don't want to do. No, we want to do some sadhana. Give me some sadhana. See? There was one seeker, he went in some remote place and there was one Pakkad Baba sitting comfortably, Pan Bidi. So he said, Maharaj, please help me. What help? Give me some instruction. I want to realize. He said, Tattvamasi, you are divine. Go. Now this seeker thought, this Baba doesn't know who am I. Therefore he is telling me I am divine. Eh? He went for a Baba ya Mahatma shopping. Another Mahatmaji, I went to that Mahatmaji, but I don't think he knows anything. Because he told me I am divine, I am Brahman. How is it possible? Now the second Mahatmaji understood the case immediately. He said, yes, without doing sadhana, how can you be divine? Sadhana you have to do. Then, it is good you have come. We have got 200 cows. And a worker have gone. See, God has sent you to do the seva of the Gomata. So every day, clean the cow dung, wash the cows. There should not be smell of cow dung and urine anywhere in the byre. And continue doing it as your sadhana. You are serving Gomata. One day, 2 days, 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 2 years, 12 years he did. And then he said, Maharaji, you told me come after 12 years. Now 12 years are over. He said, yes, I remember. Tomorrow come, early morning, but come with a proper bath, clean clothes. You are smelling like a cow dung and urine. 12 years when you live in a cow dung urine, what else will you smell? He came. And after that, sit down. You are divine. You are Brahman. He got so wild. The same thing that Mahatma told me. And after 12 years you tell me the same thing. You did not listen to him. Therefore you have to clean the cow dung. If you don't listen to me, you will have to clean the human dung. Are you ready? See, friends, we ourselves are not ready to accept. Who can help us? Because it has gone so deep in our head. Yoga karo, yoga karo. See? Get out of this doing, doing, doing. Relax, relax, relax. See? Simply telling, I study Bhagavad Gita. What Bhagavad Gita studying? See? First principle I tell you in Bhagavad Gita. You will be shocked. This happened in USA, I think. One person, after my talk, he asked me this question. Swamiji, and he was from India, and supposed to be very well read, wise among the people. So after my talk was over, I said, Swamiji, I don't have any question answer. No, I want to ask you. So my host said, Swamiji, please allow me. Okay, ask. I had not taken lunch, so I had to accept. Had I taken lunch, I would have got out. Then he asked, how many verses are attributed to Dhritarashtra, Sanjay, Arjun and Bhagwan Sri Krishna? He asked me. I replied, one verse to Dhritarashtra and zero verses to Bhagwan Sri Krishna. When I said like this, he jumped out of his skin. What do you see? I said, yes, I am talking clear. There is not a single verse which is attributed to Bhagwan Sri Krishna. He said, you are telling me something different. I said, no. Show me any Bhagavad Gita book. So they got one or two. He said, show me where it is written. Bhagwan Sri Krishna. Everywhere it is written, Bhagavan Vacha. Not Bhagwan Sri Krishna. Bhagwan is Rama. Bhagwan is Krishna. Bhagwan is Shiva. There is no where it is mentioned, Bhagwan Krishna Vacha. He said, you have shattered all my reading in my whole life. I said, if you go further, you will be shattered. See, friends. Then I told him, next, you want to know? All that you talk about, karma yoga, bhakti yoga, dosh, nothing was practiced by Arjun. He was on the battlefield. He did not do yoga. Shuchodete, pradishthapim, siramasam, atmana. He didn't do all that rubbish. Then what happened in Bhagavad Gita? Nothing happened. Oh God, you are totally confusing me. I said, that is my principle. Either convince or confuse. It is easier to confuse. So I confuse and leave you. Now you work on it. See, friends, therefore, all these things that Pap, Punya, Dharma, Adharma, this is all KG1, KG2. Now you are in a gym. So here, like the individual part space is not contaminated as much as the total space is not contaminated, in the same manner, as much as the absolute reality is the divinity, so much so we are the same divine. Then who are we? In this example, we are a pot. In Hindi, they call the body of the woman as matka and the body of the man as ghat. Because men are ghatiya and woman matakti hai. Matka, ghatka. Whatever may be the conditioning, you are divine. Insist. Aham Brahmasmi. See, my friends, this is what is the real spiritual practice. Otherwise, we simply keep on struggling. Now here, doubts are raised. These two doubts I'll read, we'll learn them in the evening class. Jnanodayat purarabdham karma jnanana nashati adatva swafalam laksham uddishyot srushta banavata vyagra buddhya vinir mukto banaha paschatu gomato na tishtati vinateva laksham vegen nirvaram. Here the question is raised that it is said that the prarabdha karma you have to go through, there is no option. Like an arrow shot from the bow, once it has left, you can't stop it. In the same manner, prarabdha gathitam, this body is made out of the prarabdha, it will have to go through that course till the prarabdha is over. And you tell, there is no prarabdha, no sanchita, no agami, how can we accept it? So keep on suffering till evening class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.